Hi, today we're gonna talk about NV-Series Network Video Endpoint Peripherals that allow native video distribution in the Q-SYS ecosystem.
Or in layman's terms, we can route HDMI video and audio over the network. Yay!
Audio video control, here we come!
Now, whether you are transporting that audio and the video from one side of the meeting room to the other, or all the way across an entire campus, as long as they're in the same network and a part of your Q-SYS design, you can do it.
In this video series, we're gonna cover the basics of video formats and protocols. We'll take a look at the ins and outs of the device and the codec, as well as how to wire it inside Q-SYS Designer software.
And because we're talking about video, you better believe we're gonna jam this series with all the movie quotes we can. So hold on to your butt,
because we're turning it up to 11. The first thing to know is that there's only one model of the NV-Series, the NV32H. We don't have a separate encoder model and a decoder model because this single unit is software definable, which means that you can configure it as an encoder or a decoder within the software. It's the one.
If you look at the back of the unit, you'll notice it has three HDMI inputs and two HDMI outputs. When the unit is set as an encoder, you're primarily bringing HDMI video and audio into the Q-SYS ecosystem. However, you can also use one of the HDMI outputs as a display for these local HDMI inputs as well, for use in a confidence monitor scenario. Likewise, when the device is set as a decoder, you're primarily decoding HDMI video sources from the network to one or two displays, again, depending on your desired resolution. However, in addition to decoding video sources from the network, you can also switch to one of the three local HDMI inputs on the device for local switching options as well.
If you haven't caught on yet, this one model is incredibly versatile. But don't worry, you can cross the streams as much as you want.
I thought you said crossing the streams was bad.
No, not in this case.
The other really cool thing about the NV-Series is its codec, or the way it handles compression and decompression.
If you know anything about video distribution, especially for the meeting room, you know that you're always trying to strike this gentle balance between quality, bandwidth, and latency. And you probably also know that sometimes IT personnel are cautious about putting video on the network, for fear that it will gobble up bandwidth unnecessarily.
However, the NV-Series uses Q-SYS's proprietary video codec called Shift, which dynamically adjusts the network bandwidth required based on the content being displayed, which affords massive network bandwidth savings for most common meeting room installations. You see, Shift codec doesn't necessarily retransmit every single pixel in every single frame if that content has not changed.
Think about a meeting in which you're displaying a graph on a PowerPoint presentation. That graphic isn't going to change for a while. In a boring meeting, maybe not for a really long while.
Who wants to read first? I'll go. So this shows that
So Shift provides an incredibly clear clarity of content while minimizing the bandwidth required. And you can see the change in that bandwidth in the control panel too. However, Shift looks incredible with full motion video as well. It just means that the system will require higher bandwidth during that time.
Finally, it's worth noting that all of the video routing and control is happening at the software layer within the Q-SYS environment. There's no separate hardware endpoint manager or control processor because it's all managed by the Q-SYS core.
In the next video, we'll be going over the basics behind video formats, HDCP and EDID, along with a few specific resolution and stream counts from each NV32H peripheral. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.